So where we are, this is the user defined method and this is the anvil method. But my question is, I want to print M1, then how will you print M1? Okay, you guys are very new in the code Java, so don't worry about that. Okay, so again this question will come, without main method can I print M1? No, right? We are able to compile, but without main method we can't print, right? Same error will come. I'm able to compile this code, but runtime we are getting this again, main method is not defined, please define the main method. So you know what is the importance of the main method. Without main method you cannot execute your code, whatever you are writing, but without main method you can't do this. So why JVM is given this main method? If you are creating any method, then JVM is not able to interact. Like any user can create a different method, right? But JVM is not able to interact, you know, users and JVM. Then JVM guys has created one method that is called the main method, and this is the interface between main method and user defined method. Okay, so how will you print M1? Who knows Java, just tell me. Hey, how will you print M1 method? Meenakshi, you have to give the answer. Able to hear me?
Yeah, I can hear you. So can you try? Yeah,
yes?
I would like to try. So yeah. This like M1, you have to put in like line number 8.
Okay, inside this main method. Okay.
Yeah.
So your answer is right, but I will tell you, this static method is there. Okay, this is a static method, and
I just give this print statement.
No, we have to call. Okay, without call we can't.
I'm sorry.
Okay. Yeah, so this is the a static method. Okay, so a static method you can call directly here. So before, we don't have a main method. Okay, so if you don't have a main method, then JVM is not able to interact for this code, whatever the code we are writing, and JVM. But that's why main method is important. If you will write any logic, if you have a thousand, like 100 method is there inside this method, you have a logic is there. So you have to call this method. So how will you call this method? Method calling means we are executing the logic. Okay, we are executing the logic. So that's why if you will call inside this main method, then this method will also execute. You can see. But I will tell you the.
Wait.
I'll tell you. Okay. Now just we are able to print right. M1. I'll tell you what is the call, the meaning of the call. Okay, this is the method. Okay, this is the method name. This is the user defined method. You guys, I will tell you, you are definitely not able to understand all the stuff now, but my question is there, why we are using main method. So you guys able to understand what is the importance of the main method? Main method, if you are not writing in the code, you are not able to run this code. That is the importance of the main method. But someone will ask why? Because we are the users, we are the programmer. The programmer is not interacting with the JVM, Java Virtual Machine. So that's why the JVM people have given one method that is called the main method. So if you are writing the any code, execution starts from the main method. So that's why main method is mandatory here. Okay, and she asked what is the call. So this, just you understand, this is the static method and this is the void non-return type, and this is the method name, like the main method, right? Like the main method. So this is the method name. Okay, I will come how to create a method, what is the rules of the method. So if you are writing any logic, I did not call this method. Okay, M1 I did not call. Okay, you can see just compile this code and just I run. So you can say I'm not able to print M1. So if you are creating any method, then you have to call this method. But your question is how to call this method, right? How to call this method? So method calling means we are, you know, giving this, you know, this is called the method signature. So this is the static method. This is the static method. So a static method you can call directly like that. If you will, what will happen? It will execute when main method will be execute, this logic will also execute. So if you will not call this main method, then this logic will be not executed. So are you able to understand, Preeti, what is the meaning of call? So I will come this, this is the static method, so you can call directly. What is the meaning of non-static and all, I will come this. Just my agenda is here, you have to understand what is the use of the main method. If you are not writing the main method, then what is the importance of the main method and why we are writing the main method. Now what I had discussed, you have any doubt? If you have any doubt, then you can ask again, I will explain. Guys, you have any doubt for this line of the piece? I told you, you are not able to understand all the stuff. But my agenda is why we are writing the class keyword. Second thing, why we are using this main method. Okay. So this is the my agenda, why we are writing this stuff. You have any doubt regarding this code?
No, sir.
Others, Preeti, are you able to understand? Or others member? Do you have any doubt? If you have any doubt, anything, any word, you having a like doubt, oh, why this is coming like that, then I will explain once. Guys, can I go ahead?
Yes.
Okay. So now I will come in the theory. Okay, whatever the theory, you know, required. So in the theory I did not write anything, but the practical session I will explain once. That's, I will give you the introduction of the Java. Okay, so this is the introduction of the Java, beginning of the core Java, who is learning. First question is why Java. Okay, Java is a programming language mainly designed to develop internet application by providing the platform independency and C and C++ programming language. What is the meaning of internet application? Internet application means web application. Okay, internet application means I have written here web application. Whatever the web application is there, any web application, you know, developed by Java, but now these new different technologies coming, but Java is using everywhere. Okay, providing platform dependency. What is the meaning of platform independency? Not dependency, independency. Can you tell me what is the operating system? How many operating system is there? Operating system? Which operating system you are using in your system?
Windows,
right? Yeah, so Linux, Windows, Mac. So this is the different operating system. Platform independency means if you will develop your application anywhere, like this code, you know, I develop one project in the Windows system, this code will, this application will work in your Linux, Ubuntu, Mac. So that is called platform independency. C and C++ is not, you know, this is the not independent. Okay, this is the dependent. If you will run, if you will develop in the one OS, then it will not execute in the another OS. So this is the another example of, you know, other you know, advantage of this core Java. Okay, one more thing. C and C++ programming language support developing only a standalone application. So what is the meaning of a standalone application? What is the meaning of a standalone application? a standalone application means we can use only one user, right? We can use only one users. This notebook, I am using this notebook, right? This is called a standalone application. Microsoft Office, that is called a standalone application. But if you will develop this, I can give the example of Facebook. How many millions users are there, right? So all the users are using. That is not a standalone application. So this is the one more advantage of Java programming language. Multiple users can use these applications. Okay, so you can say it can only execute in the current system, can't be executed from the remote system via the network call. Network call means whatever the web application you are using. So a standalone means only one user is able to use. So type of the application, so a standalone application, an application that can only be executed in a local system with a local call is that called a standalone application. You can tell only one user is able to use this. Internet application means web application, multiple users can use at a time, right? Facebook, the live example. Gmail is a live example. Flipkart, Amazon, so millions of the users are using application. So that application is web application is developed by the Java programming language. So another advantage of the Java, the multiple user will use this application. Okay, so this is called internet application. Okay, so definition of the Java, what is the Java? So first question was why Java. So you get the conclusion right here. It is a platform independencies, it multi users can use. So that is internet application we can develop by using developing this internet application. The advantage of the millions of the user can use our application. Okay, so definition of the Java. Java is very simple, high level, secure, platform independent, object oriented programming language. Okay, so you can see in the one line the Java definition is there. Simple means why the people are telling simple, but the people are telling very tough core Java, right? Hey, have you tried to learn before core Java, anyone? Have you tried to learn core Java, anyone? Yeah, you learn anywhere? Hello? Not responding. Have you learned core Java before? What you output got from others, it is a very hard and all, right? But it is a very simple, really it is a simple. Okay, and high secure means it is having a good security. Net banking application, how it is secured? If it is not secure, what will happen? Huge losses will happen, right? Because of security. So this is a secured, platform independent. We had already discussed object oriented programming language means hook concept. Hook concept means I will come. One more topic is there. Big topic is there, that is called hook concept. Hook concept means object oriented programming language. Means I will give you the little bit in introduction. You can write class name. If you have written this class name, then this is the object. Class name is an object. So what will happen internally, this class, a lot of the things is there in the OOPS concept, polymorphism, encapsulation, abstraction. So this is the the thing, how to secure the thing and how to reuse the thing. Okay, so this will comes in the OOPS concept, but little bit I will tell you, whatever the object you are writing, that object will convert in the programming world. Means whatever the you want to develop, employee information, right? You have to display employee information in your company, and you have to write the logic, how many employees present here and how many employees absent here. So what you have to do, you have to write the code, but employees, what employee is an object, but that employee you know, we are converting into the programming world. So this is the thing I will come in this OOPS concept, that it doesn't matter. So this is the, you know, simple definition of core Java. What is the core Java? So who developed this? It was developed by the James Gosling in Sun Microsystem in 1990. Sun Microsystem is a lab is there, but now the Code Java is acquired by the Oracle. Before it was there, but now it is acquired by the Oracle. It developed in 1990, and for the developing the internet application, it is the first version is the released in January 23, 1996. Okay, so some features of the Code Java. This is a simple, object-oriented, secure, robust, portable, high-performance, dynamic. So these are the features inside this the Code Java. Who developed Code Java? I already discussed James Gosling. This is a little bit introduction about James Gosling. So this thing nobody will ask, just you can read this later, no issue at all. So some terminology used in this programming language. So what is the meaning of source code? So this is the terminology I will use this, okay? What is the meaning of source code? Developer written the program, it is written according to the programming language syntax. Source code means, you can see here, you are developer, just I written this code like first code. So we are developer, and this code, just you can see this code, okay, this code I have written, and just I am saving this class, okay, I am saving this class here. This is my folder where I am saving this class. You can see here I save this class, and you have to save the class according whatever the your class name is there, you have to save like that, same class name. If you will give the wrong class name like that, I have given this wrong class name, see, then what will happen? You can see, if I will compile this, what will happen? Nothing we are getting, right? So here, if I will compile this, compiler is telling file not found, because you have written wrong class, you have saved your file, you know, wrong way, because the class name is this, I saved in the wrong class name. So what will happen? Compiler is able to not find this file, okay? So class name and file name your same, otherwise the compiler is not able to find name, one thing. Second thing here, the Java class always the extension is .java, by default it is taking, okay? This extension is .java, okay? So by default here it is taking, but what is the extension you have to save? .java file. It is the .java file, okay? But my question is, what is the source code? Now I have developed this code, I execute one time, right? Okay, so whatever the code you are developing, okay, that is called the source code. Okay, whatever the code first time we are developing, and we did not compile this code and we did not execute this code, that code is called source code. Okay, this code is called source code. Now understood, right? The developer written the program, it is written in the according to the programming syntax language. Just we have written this code, I did not compile this, I did not run this, that is called source code. Now second is called, what is the compile code? Compiler generated program, that is called converted from the source code. Okay, whatever the, you know, if you will compile the code, then compiler will generate another code, okay, that is called the compiled code. If I write any code, okay, that is called the source code. If you will compile that code, that is called the, you know, compiled code. Now, what is the meaning of compiler? It is just a translation program that converts the source code into the machine language at once. Okay, what will happen if you will compile this code? If you will compile this code, then you can see here, one, after compilation this, here you can see one more file they will generate. That file is called .java class file. Okay, if you are compiling this code, what will happen? Compiler will generate one more file that is called .class file. Okay, after compilation this file will be generated. This is nothing but this is called white code, or you can tell this is called machine language code. Means this code is able to understand our machine, right? We are writing this code. This is the simple Java code, right? Dot Java file. This is the simple Java code. This is the simple Java code. But what will happen? This is the human readable. I am able to read, you are able to read, right? But after compilation, one more file will be generated, that is called dot class file. This is the machine readable file, means machine is able to read. What is this code? This code is called bytecode. Okay, this is called compiler generated code. Okay, so this is the thing, the compiler. What is the compiler? It is a translation program that converts into source code into the machine language at once. At once means it will convert at once. Okay, but what is the difference between the interpreter? It is also a translation program that converts the source code into the machine code, but what the interpreter is doing, it is doing line by line, but compiler is doing at one shot. So sometime they can ask, as you, if you will go as a fresher interview, what is the difference between the compiler and interpreter? So this is your interview question. So what is the meaning of executable code? Executable means the extension is exe file. OS means operating system, you know, understand the readability of executed program. Can you tell me which application we are using which is having a .exe file in my system? Okay, lot of the thing I am using here, right? Edit Plus, this Notepad. So which application, you know, which is developed this, and it is that is called the exe file? Understood my question? Yeah, you can tell this you are using this Notepad, right? This Notepad who developed, you know, this is called exe file. So OS understandable readability and executable of this file. Okay, so you know, C++ and C, the extension is .exe file. Okay, so this is not a big thing, just this is a file extension I am telling you. Compilation, it is a process for translating source code into the compile code. Same thing, right? If you are doing compilation, then one more file will be generated, that is called .class file. Dot class file is nothing but this is the bytecode. Bytecode is nothing but the machine is able to understand this code. What is the meaning of execution? It is a process of running the compile code to get output. I already told you whatever I discussed here, I will give you the all the notes regarding this. If I will start only from theory, you know, then you guys are not able to understand all the stuff. So that's why I showed little bit practical. When I start this theory, you guys able to understand, oh, what is the meaning of execution, what is the meaning of compilation, how internally it is working. So understood what is the meaning of compilation and execution? Execution is a process for running the compile code to get the output. First we are compiling the code, then what will happen? Dot java class will be generated, dot java file will be generated, and after that what will happen? So dot java file is a bytecode, and that bytecode is nothing but this is the machine language code, and machine is able to understand that code. After compilation we are executing the code. Execution is nothing but we are running this program and we are getting the output. Okay, this is the execution. We have a Java technology, which what little bit introduction about of Java technology, the both platform and programming language. Platform is a hardware or software environment, right? which program are executed. Java has its own software based on that is called JVM. Okay, Java has its own software platform. What I was discussing JVM. So Java having own, you know, software platform based on that is called JVM. JVM is nothing but Java Virtual Machine, means to execute the Java program. That's why if you are not writing, if you having the Java in your system but you are writing the code, okay, on your Edit Plus, yeah, anywhere your file is .java class, sorry, .java file is there, if you are executing this without main method, then this JVM is not allowed. When you are executing this, then JVM is asking where is your main method, because if you are writing the any code, then your code, your execution will start from the main method. Then that's why JVM is always asking where is your main method. Okay, so Java having the own software, okay, like C and C++ program, Java program are not directly executable by OS. What will happen if you are writing any code of the C and C++, you can execute directly, but if you are writing any code, okay, I have written inside this code in the Edit Plus, but in my system I don't have a Java software, then what will happen, your program will not execute. Okay, your program will not execute. So what is the meaning of platform? So a platform is a hardware or software environment in which a program runs, right? For instance, the computer is operating system, system and hardware device. This is called the platform. So you can, we had already discussed what the meant by the platform, dependent and independent, right? So platform dependent means an application that is compiled in one operating system if it is not run in the different operating system. I have already discussed, if you are writing the program of C and C++, that application is developed on your Windows system, and if you want to be execute that application in your different OS like Linux, Ubuntu and anything, then what will happen, that will not work, because this is a platform dependent. Okay, that thing I have mentioned here. The programming language that is used to develop this application is called platform dependent programming language. C and C++ programming are platform dependent programming language because this language program compiled code does not run in the different OS. Platform independent, Java itself platform independent means same thing I have discussed here. If the application compiled code able to run in the different operating system, then the application is called platform independent application. The programming language that is used to develop this application is called platform independent programming language. Java is a platform independent programming language. We had already discussed in the that session, right, before. So Java is platform independent. So they can ask in the interview, can you tell me Java is platform independent or independent? So you will tell, yeah, platform independent. So someone will ask, what is the platform independent? Can you give me the example of platform independent or dependent? So you can give the example of C++ is the platform dependent and Java is the platform independent. So this is the another question. What are the Java file extension? Okay, so I had already discussed this stuff, so I will explain this. Okay, Java, we have two file extension. One is called .java extension. Whatever the file we are saving here, you can see this is the .java extension, right? This is the .java extension. And second is the .dot, means what is the meaning of this? .java extension file is called source code, which is developed by developer, means we have developed this code. And dot class extension file is called compiled code, contains the bytecode and which is generated by compiler from the source code. This is called your compiled code, or you can tell this is the source code. Source code is nothing but this is the bytecode. Bytecode is nothing but this is the machine language code. Machine is able to understand this code. Okay, so now so you can understand compile code. Okay, so like C and C++, in Java we don't have a executable file .exe extension file. Mova in the Java and compile code is not machine language. Instead of just we have written in the intermediate code names with bytecode stored in the new file with the extension. Same thing I discuss here. This code is generated by Java compiler and is only understood by the JVM. JVM, I was telling, it is, you know, able to understand by the machine. What is the machine? Meaning means that generated, you know, bytecode is generated, which bytecode is generated, and this is understandable by this JVM, Java Virtual Machine. Okay. So Java program, develop, compilation and execution procedure. Same thing I had discussed here. I discuss here like what before have done, what is the happening, you know, like that. So in Java programming language, all the source code is the first written in the plain text file, editing with .java file. Means what is the procedure and all the procedure, like if you are developing this code. So this is the code I have developed, and the extension is .java file, and what will happen, and those source file are compiled into the dot class. Then after what we are doing, after writing this code, this is called the source code. After that we are doing the compilation, right? After compilation, what will happen, into it will generate, that is called dot class file, but compiler, you know, by the compiler. This I have given this example of this is the A class, so we are getting this dot class. File does not contain code, that is the native in your processor. It contains, means here what I want to develop, what I want to say you, this code is nothing but this file contains only your bytecode. That is the native language to, you know, of the Java Virtual Machine able to understand this. So this is the compilation and generating the bytecode. Means this is the native language, you can tell. Yeah, you can tell what is the machine language. This language is able to understand JVM. Okay, so this is the thing, the Java launcher tools, then run the application and with the instance of the Java Virtual Machine, and after that we will run the code. After means we are running the code, you can tell, you can execute the code then by using this Java Virtual Machine. Okay, so this is the I want to ask one more thing. If I will explain first this theory, you know, I will start from this theory only. Are you guys able to understand what I was telling and all? But I will show you little bit this practical, at least you are able to understand what I want to say you, right? Am I right?
Yes.
Okay, that thing yesterday I was trying to do that. Okay, everything I am discussing here, right? Whatever that guy was telling. But he knows the Java, he already studied, but you guys very new in the core Java. If I will start from this theory, definitely you will feel more what you are telling and all. But I show you little bit theory, practical, then you are able to understand, oh, what is, how this code is generating, and what is the file extension, what the compiler is doing. So now it is, you are getting the clear what I am telling you. Okay? So that's why I show you little bit, you know, practical part. So this is the stuff what is happening here. Okay, this internally one file is generated. This is my program.java file is generated. After compilation, what will happen, one file will be generated, that is called my program.class file. So inside this file, what thing is there, this inside this .java class we have a bytecode. Now what will happen, again JVM, then it will interact to the JVM. So JVM, after executing this, JVM will give the output, okay, in your system. So this thing is happening internally, what, when you are writing the code, when you are compiling the code, and when you are executing the code. Okay, this is the basic stuff what we are doing here. Okay, So this is the diagram, okay, and what where we are, okay. So types of the Java software, okay. So we have a, you know, right, we have discussed, you know, JVM, JDK, JRE, but what is this? Okay, so Java software is divided into two types. One type is called JDK. JDK means Java Development Kit. The full form of JDK means Java Development Kit, and JRE means Java Runtime Environment. So there are two types of the, no, this Java software is divided into two types. Now question is, if you are going as a fresher, they will ask definitely all the stuff what I am teaching you in the starting, why Java, what is Java, what is the features of the Java, what is the platform dependent, and what is the source code, what is the white code, what is the compile code, they can ask everything, okay. So don't avoid this theory and all, this is your basics, okay. So JDK and JRE, so what is the difference between JDK, JRE and JVM, okay, I'll show you one diagram first. So Java software are divided into two parts, JDK and JRE, and now we have one thing. So this, you know, JVM, JRE, everything is, you know, is there inside this JDK. If you are installing the JDK in your, JDK is a software, like any software, you just download this, and what you are doing after downloading the software, what you are doing, installing in your system, right? Same thing, JDK is a software. So inside this JDK we have a JRE and we have a JVM. Now we will understand what is the meaning of inside this JVM and JRE. This is a compiler is also there inside this JDK. JRE is there, JVM is there, and compiler is there, okay. So now what they are doing this, okay, this JVM, JRE and JDK means, here conclusion is, one software is there, that is JDK. If you will install this software in your system, this JVM, JRE and compiler is automatically coming this in your system, okay. So now we will learn what is the use of JRE, what is the use of JVM and compiler, we already discussed, and what is the JDK, okay. So you can see here, JVM is a subset of JRE according to, you know, a picture, and JRE is a subset of JDK. When we install JDK, JRE is also installed automatically. JRE software is available as per separate package, so we can install JRE also. You know, if you want to, we are install only JRE, you can install separate, no issue at all. But why we will install separate, right? Because we have to need both, you know, JRE and JVM as well, okay. So just your knowledge purpose, if you want to, we are install only JRE, you can install separate, no issue at all, okay. So JDK has both compiler and JVM. So by using this JDK, we can develop the compile and, you know, execute the new Java application, and also we can modify and compile and execute already developed application. Okay, so these are the job. JRE has only JVM. Hence, using JRE, we can only execute already developed application. Means, if you are installing in your software only JRE, then the JRE is not able to compile your application, your code. What the JRE will do? JRE will do, only compile code is there in your system, they can only execute this, okay. So this is the difference between JRE and JDK. JDK what will do? JDK have both compiler and JVM. Means you are able to compile this and you are able to execute this. But if you will install only JRE, then what will happen? Only you are able to execute your application. Do you have any doubt regarding JDK, JVM, JRE? I will explain once. Guys, can you go ahead? If you have a doubt, then I can explain once. tell yes, no, then I can go ahead. Can I go ahead? You have any doubt regarding JRE, JDK, JVM? Hello?
No, sir, not clear.
Okay, clear, right? And already given this notes, US definitely it is clear, not a different stuff and all. So this is the little bit introduction about of all the stuff, and this diagram I have already shown you. Okay, I will send you that diagram also, and I will send you all the notes also. Okay, and so okay, then I'm not continuing this, a lot of the thing is there, so I will continue in the next session. Okay, and if I will take your class as a big days, any issue? Big days, same time. Guys, if I will take your class in the big days, same time, if you have any issue?
No.
Any others having a issue? Like, no, right? In big days. Preeti, you are able to attend the class, right? In
yes.
Big days. And Ashok, what about of you? In big days, 9 p.m. same timing. You can attend, right? No, no, big days, like I can arrange this class in the big days as well.
Okay.
Lot of the thing is there, right, in this chapter, so not I will depend upon only weekend. So big days I can also take, not every day, like alternate class like that. I will inform you in the morning time only, in today's class is there, I will ping you. So that's why.
Okay, no problem.
Okay. Sarmi, you can attend, right? No issue in big days?
No, no issue.
Okay, okay, then I will ping you regarding tomorrow class, okay? So today I am stopping this, okay. And whatever I teach you, I will send you the notes on your this email ID. And this video is also recorded. I will upload my YouTube channel. Just what you have to do, just I will send you the link also. Just download this video. Might be I can do the private letters. Okay. 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 Then I'll continue next class. Okay. Later. Okay. Then good night. Bye, all of you.
Bye.
Okay. Bye.